to Stecker in front, followed closely by Boyle. Coming down the outside was Chavis, but it's Doyle. Stecker wins the second first.
Long before Rio and the latest drug controversies, one small nation mastered the dark art of doping.
It was done like an animal experiment.
They wanted to be noticed. They wanted to tell the world, we are bigger, we are more powerful, we are smarter.
Tonight, the women whose lives were destroyed by their own government for the sake of Olympic glory.
They gave virilizing drugs, higher dosages to female persons than even to the male persons, because they noticed it gives so much more medals.
The illnesses that they've had in the deformed babies scares me.
And the famous Australian who lost out on gold.
I was beaten by a woman who was on very high levels of testosterone.
Is she smearing you?
Absolutely. What she's doing is she's trying to cover up her own problem. They were just pawns in the big game.
So you never doped?
No.
Tremendous changing from the East Germans. And here comes the flying Gurr. The time to look for, 41.53. Can she do it? It's going to be very close. Yes, she has another world record for the German Democratic Republic.
Marlies Gurr was once the fastest woman in the world, a shining star of East Germany's track and field super squad in the 70s and 80s, especially in the 100 metres.
Ich bin ja insgesamt 38 Mal unter 11 gelaufen, also das ist schon eine riesen Leistung, die jetzt kaum noch jemand so ausweisen kann. This is from Seoul, it's a silver medal.
Silver medal.
And this is from gold. Moscow, the gold from the Wheelie.
Today, her house in Jena, in the eastern part of Germany, is littered with Olympic honours.
In Canberra, the East Germany team.
At the 1985 Athletics World Cup in Canberra, Marlies Gurr was at the top of her game.
This was a relay.
Yeah. So this is you taking the baton. Yeah. Wow, what a moment.
Und wir in der Staffel den Weltrekord mit 41,37, der dann über 30 Jahre Bestand hatte. Also vor 4 Jahren ist der erst gebrochen worden.
But the whole time Marlies Gurr was winning, she was part of a nation where, by law, all athletes had to take performance-enhancing drugs. For the former East Germany, sporting glory was international proof of communist superiority. And the drugs worked. For 20 years, until it ceased to exist, East Germany was almost always second in the Olympic medal tally, despite a population of only about 17 million. The doping program was shrouded in secrecy. No one asked and no one told.
Were tablets part of your program?
Nee, also das für mich war keine Pillenprogramm. Sicherlich hast du Vitamine eingenommen, die werden bestimmt viele einnehmen, aber...
Did you ever ask what they were?
Das sicher habe ich nicht nachgefragt, musste ich auch nicht.
Marlies Gurr completely rejects that her success is due to doping. She says, like other athletes from the former East Germany, she put years of hard work into strength and fitness.
Man kann sich nicht vorstellen, man kann jetzt ein Medikament einnehmen oder Tablette und du bist schnell oder bist du springst weiter oder wirfst die Kugel weiter, gehört schon ganz viel Training dazu. Und
dass diese nicht nach Australien fahren darf.
But a fellow runner, Ines Geipel, has no illusions about her sporting achievements.
Dass dich eventuell konkretes Wissen erreichen könnte, auch weg. So. Also man war ein williger, ein nützlicher Idiot.
Ines Geipel and Marlies Gurr were relay teammates at the same East German sports club, SC Motor Jena.
Bin ich mit 17 gekommen und man hat sofort mit der Chemie begonnen.
Did you know that they were performance enhancing drugs?
Ich weiß, dass ich mich in dem Moment belogen habe, aber ich habe mich nicht bewusst belogen, sondern ich war so stolz. Mein Körper war so stark, meine Brust ging zurück. Das habe ich gesehen, aber ich dachte, es ist das Krafttraining.
You look almost afraid. Were you enjoying yourself?
Ich glaube, ich war sehr konzentriert und skeptisch und jung und nein, ich war nicht glücklich in der Zeit. Und ich finde, man sieht so wie so eine Maschine aus. Ja? So.
How many people were doped? Did they dope an entire generation?
Ja, jeder, der die Medaille gewonnen hat.
And many who didn't. Thousands of athletes who never made it to the podium were also doped. It started early. Many of those given drugs were children.
Aber viele haben berichtet, dass die Trainer oder eben auch die Ärzte aufgepasst haben, dass die Tablette wirklich zerbissen wurde. Also man hat richtig den Mund der Kinder festgehalten, damit die das nicht ausspucken, weil natürlich Kinder auch, ja, also nicht jedes Kind nimmt gerne eine Tablette. Ja? Also viele wurden ja auch gezwungen, regelrecht dazu.
After her sporting career ended abruptly at age 24, Ines Geipel would pay a high price for 7 years of performance-enhancing drugs.
Hatte wahnsinnige Schwierigkeiten mit Nieren und also die inneren Organe waren vergiftet.
But the full picture wouldn't be revealed until after the Berlin Wall came down in 1989. Ending the huge control the East German regime had over its citizens.
It may not look so threatening, but this is a fragment of the 44 kilometers of wall which snaked throughout Berlin. Today, it's a tourist attraction. But for many former residents of East Germany, this wall still represents a past which is difficult to escape.
Former citizens had been spied upon extensively by the Stasi, the secret police. When Ines Geipel obtained access to her Stasi file, she realized the full extent of how she'd been doped. And formally removed her name from athletic records.
Und dann war für mich das eigentlich so logisch, dass ich dachte, ich kann ja nicht einen Rekord festhalten, der nicht stimmt.
She's set up a support group for former East German athletes and has led legal battles to hold the coaches and trainers accountable, making her a lot of enemies, including her former teammate, Marlies Gurr.
Ines Geipel war nobody, war gar nichts. Sie war nie Nationalmannschaft, sie war nur einmal in der Clubstaffel gewesen und sie profiliert sich jetzt sehr in der ganzen Problematik.
Ja, also es bleibt schon, also das Märchen ist natürlich immer angenehmer und jede Gesellschaft, die sich, die den Sport braucht, um irgendwie zu strahlen, wird eben Leute wie mich immer angreifen. Also diese Art von Attacken, physischer oder auch anderer Art, wird in die Wohnung eingebrochen oder das Auto wird mit Farbeimern beschmiert oder es gibt heftige Leserbriefreaktionen in Sendern.
For those wanting to know what East Germany was like, the DDR Museum in Berlin is a gallery of life under communism, from the quirky to the kitsch. Amongst the bric-a-brac is something more sinister.
Today, the most commonly used drug in East Germany is now a museum curiosity. Doping in East Germany was officially known as supporting means. And supporting means usually meant oral turinabol, a highly effective anabolic steroid.
On the other side of Berlin, there's another very different archive which documents this dark past. It exists thanks to the efforts of one man. Because in the frantic cover-up at the end of the East German regime, a lot of Stasi files were destroyed.
It was noticed that secrecy documents, very secret documents, were destroyed in the shredder machines. Actually, so much that many shredder machines, you know, got broken. They were running day and night.
German microbiologist Professor Werner Franke was asked by the government to examine scientific research from the former East Germany and realised some documents had been overlooked by the shredders.
Then I noticed, oh, there's still maybe something left. And there was a room next to a library where indeed top secret doctoral thesis, for example, was taught, still intact.
He saved as much as he could. Today, the Werner Franke archive holds an extraordinary history of how a state doped athletes en masse for more than two decades. The files reveal in painstaking detail dates, dosages, and names of trainers, coaches, and athletes.
By far the most commonly used drug, especially for muscle enhancement, strength development, etc., but also for endurance. And in all discipline, especially, for women was a drug called oral turinabol, which the DDR had developed.
An anabolic steroid, oral turinabol, was created by the state-owned pharmaceutical company VEB Jena Farm. Its devastating impact was particularly pronounced in women.
Better word was virilizing drugs. This doping is nothing but virilization, making female bodies full male bodies. Painful deepening of the voice, you know, that other people noticed was sometimes up to 30%. And if a person who no longer took the drugs then became pregnant. Also, club feet were very surprisingly frequent, but that is known because the uterus was, you know, shrunk by these virilizing drugs. So in this tight-fitting uterus, for example, legs and feet could not develop.
So this is the report of the coach of the relay team, and he admits to doping his athletes?
Yeah, not only admits, very precisely. He says how many tablets the persons have got, in which time period, so with all details.
In 1974, East Germany actually passed a law saying all elite athletes had to dope, trainers and coaches had to dope them, and no one was allowed to talk about it. Despite her denials, amongst the files we find the name of Marlies Gurr.
And that says 1 to 2 tablets every day.
Yeah. And then you see also the years. For example, Marlies Gurr got them from 1975 until 1988.
Wow, so she was doping for 13 years.
Yeah, and she was doping already when she was under 18. That's documented several times.
The old anabolic steroids, like oraltorinibol, are still being used by today's athletes looking for a pharmaceutical edge. Because, although they have horrific side effects, they work. Some of the former East German world records still stand. Others were only toppled recently. To this day, Werner Franke still faces opposition to his work.
It is considered to be not in the interest of the nation, not in the interest of, you know, the fame, etc. So whoever this had, there's a name for that in German, East as well as West. Sportverräter. Sports traitor.
I've been told there's a chance one of the most elusive figures of the communist glory days will talk to us, but there are no guarantees. In a Belgian hotel bar, we meet Olympic medalist Renate Stecker. Stecker is well known to Australians. At the 1972 Munich Games, she took gold in the 100 and 200 metre sprint races, leaving Australia's Raylene Boyle with silver. She denies that her success was due to doping. She puts it down to hard work and training.
Ich finde, man kann überhaupt nicht einfach sagen, die DDR-Sportler waren generell gedopt. Das ist ein falsches Urteil, was man da.
But according to the documents we're shown from the Werner Franke archive, a doctor from Renate Stecher's athletics club says that under her maiden name, Meissner, she would not have achieved her success without the appropriate medications. Renate Stecker says Stasi files can't be trusted because informants were unreliable.
Aber viele hatten auch ihren Job zu erledigen, mussten irgendwas berichten. Und dadurch, denke ich mir, kam natürlich auch vieles in die Akten rein, was gar nicht der Realität entsprach. Dass man vielleicht ein paar alte Bilder, also.
She's tired of having to justify her achievements and dismisses comments from her sporting nemesis, Raylene Boyle.
Ich habe ja schon mit ihr ein Interview gemacht vor vielen, vielen Jahren. Da hat sie mich ja konkret angeklagt. Sie konnte weder irgendwas beweisen noch irgendwelche Dinge vorbringen. Also das fand ich schon sehr unter der Gürtellinie, muss ich mal so sagen. Und wenn sie immer Zweite ist, kann ich jetzt mal sagen, wieso war sie dann immer Zweite?
You were still running in 1976 and it was law in 1974 that everyone had to dope.
Ich verstehe die Fragestellung überhaupt nicht. Es Pflicht war, ich kenne mich nicht aus, was Pflicht gewesen ist. Ich war Athlet und ich kann nur über mich selber sprechen und ich kann nur sagen, dass es sauber und ordentlich zugegangen ist.
So you never doped?
No.
But as our conversation draws to a close, she can't quite let the Raylene Boyle topic go.
Ist schon gut.
Anyway.
Yeah. Also mit Real Boyle, es ist sehr kompliziert.
Mm.
Sehr kompliziert.
Mm. Ja.
Wenn ich so viel, ich erste so viel und sie zweite so viel, kann man da von Doping sprechen? Ich Doping, sie kein Doping? Geht das?
Okay, so now she's saying that I probably doped as well.
What's your response to that? Did you dope?
No. No, I had no reason to. I was a gifted athlete. If I doped, I would have told the world, because I've got a big mouth and I've got nothing to hide.
I've come from Europe to Queensland to meet Raylene Boyle, to see what she has to say about Renate Stecher's comments after so many years.
I feel very sad for Renate, because she's still towing the East German line. She was told what to say for all of her running career, all of her life. And she is still toeing the line.
Some former East German athletes have had really serious health impacts from doping. Do you feel sorry for them?
Yes, I do. As we know, the Eastern European countries, people didn't have a choice. They still don't in countries like Russia and China, I'm sure. They could make something of themselves if they did it, so it was worthwhile. The illnesses that they've had and the deformed babies scares me. And I think that's an awful thing to live with for that moment of glory for your country.
Es ist immer schwierig, also die Wahrheit in der eigenen Vergangenheit zu sehen, zu suchen, zu finden. Und ich denke, es lässt sich für viele auch mit einer Lüge leichter leben.
Uwe Trümmer was once a cyclist for East Germany. He started to train seriously at the age of 14. And the doping began soon after.
Diese Pillen, die wurden eigentlich zu verschiedenen Zeiten verteilt. Also die waren in bestimmten Trainingslagern, lagen diese Pillen einfach mit auf dem Teller drauf, also mit verschiedenen anderen Pillen. Und dann gab es noch die sogenannten Cocktails, die gespritzt wurden.
When he tried to refuse the shots, the repercussions were spelt out.
Und da habe ich gesagt, stopp. Also das will ich nicht. Und da wurde mir ganz klipp und klar gesagt, wenn du dich nicht spritzen lässt, dann kannst du nach Hause fahren, dann kannst du auch dein Rad an den Nagel hängen, dann bist du ja nicht mehr erwünscht. Dass ich Ja gesagt habe, damals hat mich ja fast das Leben gekostet.
Uwe Trümmers professional cycling career ended abruptly when he was 23. He'd been on a round of injections for more than 3 weeks when he went for a regular training ride and fell from his bike.
Immer weniger Luft bekommen und ja, also es war eine extrem lebensgefährliche Situation für mich und mir wurde halt immer erklärt, dass es halt alles, ich hätte nur eine normale Erkältung. Ja, und bei dem schwarzen Urin bin ich dann natürlich halt auch drauf gekommen, dass es keine Erkältung ist, aber auch dafür wurde mir keine Erklärung gegeben. Und ich wurde einfach nicht in die Klinik gebracht. Und das war im Prinzip damals fast mein Todesurteil. Also, ich habe mich ja nicht von dem Sport verabschiedet. Der Sport hat sich von mir verabschiedet. Also, die haben mich entfernt, also rausgeschnitten aus dem Sportlerleib.
Just last month, the German government passed a second law awarding modest compensation to athletes who were doped. Uwe has received compensation and now lives on a disability pension. He's suffered high blood pressure, damaged joints, kidney failure, and a decade ago he had a stroke, all of which he says are the result of his earlier doping and tough training regimen.
Also diese Giftstoffe, die haben sich sozusagen bei mir auf der Gehirnoberfläche abgelagert. Also sind hier oben drauf. Und zu dem Zeitpunkt des Schlaganfalls sah meine Gehirnoberfläche aus wie so ein netter Schweizer Käse. Das heißt also, wenn ich diesen Schlaganfall nicht bekommen hätte, hätte das dort oben in aller Fröhlichkeit weiter mein Gehirn zerfressen können und dann würde ich heute mit Sicherheit nicht mehr hier sitzen.
He's not the only one with serious health conditions.
Discussion in this week in the media.
Ines Geipel is in touch with hundreds of former East German athletes whose health has deteriorated significantly in middle age.
Gesamtes Skelett ist sowas von verbraucht. Ja? Also wir haben Athleten, die sind jetzt Mitte 40, haben 2 künstliche Hüften, 2 künstliche Knie, können sich überhaupt nicht mehr bewegen. So, ja? Sehr, sehr schwere Organschäden, vor allen Dingen Herz, also verkalktes Herz, Herzinfarkte. Sehr viele Dialysepatienten, also Niere, Leber kaputt. sehr, sehr viele psychische Erkrankungen, extreme. Und ja, ich glaube, ich bin jetzt schon mit einer der Ältesten.
Doping wasn't the only way in which the Stasi damaged sports people. At a training camp in Mexico in 1984, Ines Geipel met and fell in love with a local athlete. She decided she would defect, but the Stasi got wind of her plans.
Man wollte mich, war zum Feind geworden. Also ein DDR-Athlet, der fliehen will, das war ein absolutes No-Go. Ja, also das war so gefährlich. Und dann hat man eben meinen Körper attackiert. Also man hat mir eine Operation angetragen und im Grunde mich zerstört, also den Bauch verstümmelt.
She was told she needed to undergo a routine appendectomy. Instead, they cut through the muscles in her stomach.
In der Stasi-Akt über mich habe ich dann gefunden, zum Beispiel, steht an der Stelle, jetzt haben wir endlich die Möglichkeit, sie auf Eis zu legen.
Following the surgery, Ines Geipel couldn't run. That meant she couldn't compete internationally, and nor could she ever have children. Her Stasi file revealed an even darker secret. Her own father had been informing on her. He was a top-ranking officer from the Stasi's terror unit.
Ich nehme an, eben gerade, das hat mit der Position meines Vaters zu tun, dass dieser Befehl für diesen Akt, ja, diese Operation von dort gekommen ist. Ich lese dieses DDR-Staatsdoping auch als einen großen politischen Opferungsprozess. Diese Eltern haben ihre Kinder dem Staat gegeben, geschenkt. Also es ist unwahrscheinlich viel Kriminelles in der Zeit des DDR-Sports an den Athleten. Es war das billigste Material, ja, durchexerziert worden.
So it was done like in animal experiments. Actually, it was done in a way you wouldn't be allowed to do it with animals.
Ja, aber in jedem von uns tickt einfach mit dem Doping auch eine Zeitbombe. Und ob die nun mit 30 hoch, also explodiert, oder mit 70 explodiert, ist völlig egal. Also und das ist ja auch genau das Gefährliche am Doping.
The IOC is tarnished for me. We're talking about a big business, awful lot of money. And I think the athletes are the pawns to a certain degree. And I think it's about time they stood up and were counted just like the athletes have to be if they are caught taking something.